ChatGPT 4, OpenAI's most powerful language model, has certainly proven itself superior to its predecessor, the still free ChatGPT 3.5. But if you want access to it, you're going to have to shell out $20 per month, at least in the US. But is ChatGPT 4 worth it? We're going to cover everything you need to know to make an informed decision. To answer this question, we'll need to get a sense for 1. Just how much better is ChatGPT 4 than 3.5? And 2. What can you do with ChatGPT 4 that you can't do with 3.5? And before we jump in, make sure to hit that subscribe button if you want to keep the AI world in your orbit. Okay, let's get started with the most obvious question. Just how much better is ChatGPT 4? ChatGPT 3.5 is trained on a massive dataset, but ChatGPT 4's is 10 times larger, which means it's significantly better at comprehension of context, and it's 40% more likely to produce factual responses. But it also means that it takes a bit longer to respond. So if a quick response is what you're after, GPT 3.5 may be for you. ChatGPT 4 is also multimodal, which means it can accept other inputs as context for prompts, like images and spreadsheets. While 3.5 is primarily text-based, and because of its multimodality and huge database size, GPT 4 is capable of substantially more complex tasks. According to OpenAI, GPT 4 performed significantly better on about half of the US standardized tests it was given, while on other subjects there was no improvement or a small incremental improvement. Among the tests it performed at least 2 times better on are advanced mathematics, like calculus, trigonometry, statistics, and algebra. Several science categories, like advanced chemistry, advanced physics 2, biology, and macroeconomics. And it also improved a ton in the contextual understanding required for law exams, like the bar exam, which it did 10 times better on, and the LSAT, which it did 2 times better on. On the other end, there were several categories which saw no improvement, like English literature, writing, psychology, world history, and US government. That's an important data point to consider when it comes to standardized tests. GPT 4 is no better than 3.5 on writing, which is arguably its primary purpose. GPT 4 also has a bigger context window. Have you ever noticed that halfway through a conversation with ChatGPT, that it seems to have forgotten some information that you gave it in a previous prompt? This is because the conversation has extended beyond the context window, which is essentially a memory limitation to limit computational resources. ChatGPT 4 has a 2 times larger context window, so not only will it remember 2 times more, but it can also accept 2 times larger single prompts. Moving on to the more interesting question. What can you do with ChatGPT Plus that you can't do without it? To start, we've got Dall-e, which is an easy-to-use image generator, but as you can see, it pales in comparison to Midjourney and Leonardo AI. Next up, Data Analyst. Data Analyst is, in my opinion, the most powerful ChatGPT feature because it allows you to do in seconds what used to take hours of spreadsheet work. Here, I'll show you. Let's go over to Kaggle and grab a sample dataset. Okay, this one works. It's a simple dataset with information about tortillas sold in Mexico. It gives us the location, date, store type, and price for each tortilla sale. Let's upload the dataset and ask Data Analyst for some descriptive statistics and charts about it. Right off the bat, we get our descriptive statistics and can see that the average price per kilo of tortillas in Mexico is 12 pesos. But there is high variation in pricing based on the standard deviation of 4. It can also generate basic charts. This is the distribution of tortilla prices, which we can verify for correctness by checking out the graph Kaggle gave us. It also gave us a box and whispers plot, as well as time series data, from which we can tell that tortilla prices have been rapidly rising since 2008. Okay, now let's move on to some custom GPTs, which are crafted by community members and add a ton of value to the GPT Plus plan. There are thousands of custom GPTs available, but only a handful that work really well. So I'm going to walk through the ones that work and have actually improved my productivity. Let's start with PDF AI, which allows you to chat with your PDFs. It can interpret both text and images. For example, I uploaded a research report about aspartame's impact on the human body and asked about the image on page 2, which is an image of the chemical makeup of aspartame. And it gave us a great summary of the study, as well as an accurate description of the image. Then there's whimsical diagrams, which allows you to describe some kind of process or flow that you want to make into a chart, like a lead generation funnel for an e-commerce store. And Whimsical will create it for you in a way that is editable on the Whimsical platform. So you would click this link here, and that would take you to Whimsical, where you could edit these different elements, drag them around, etc. I find this really useful when I have a complex project or problem to solve, as I can map it out in just a few moments and look at key points. Next up, we've got Chart Generator, which is like a more powerful version of Data Analyst that's optimized for data visualizations. So it's going to be better at creating visualizations generally, but can also create 3D charts. So to demonstrate that, we've asked for a 3D chart of aspartame's impact on the brain. And as you can see, it gave us a 3D chart where we can see each chemical and its impact level. But let's say you wanted more of a diagram with a human brain as the center point. Let's see if we can get that by asking it for a diagram with the primary element being an image of a human brain. Okay, so it provided a diagram with the human brain as the central point, so it understood that much. But if we zoom in here, it looks like the text is not actually human text. So you'd need to incorporate Canva or another design tool to complete the program. Moving on to another powerful GPT. Tutor.me is a tool for learning. It can help you generate personalized lesson plans and run you through exercises. Currently, it works best with math, science, and humanities subjects. To demonstrate, I asked it for a data analytics lesson plan and then asked it to run me through an exercise. Really cool. And since we're talking about learning, Language Learner is the go-to GPT for learning languages. It has several different built-in language exercises, including this one, which uses Dall-e to generate images and asks you to describe the scene. And the last, more general GPT I'm going to talk about is Consensus, which is a research assistant made to help you pass through those wordy, dense research papers. For example, I asked what evidence we have that climate change is human-driven and was met with a heap of evidence on the matter, which links to the studies themselves. Now that we've covered the most generally useful GPTs, let's dive into the GPTs that can be used to level up your stock and crypto trading. Starting with Market Analyst, which helps predict stock market trends and movements in individual stocks. I'll ask it to identify some stocks for potential growth. As you can see, it recommended a few different stocks that have had great growth. Let's ask about the current price of Supermicrocomputer, SMCI, and compare that to what we get on Google. Yep, we've got the same price, $1,068.83. Let's say we're thinking about buying SMCI, right? So let's ask if it's a good buy. Market Analyst looks at historical performance, analyst opinions, and market trends to give us an answer. But if you're not interested in stocks, well, there's a similar GPT for crypto called CryptoScope. When we ask it for the latest crypto news, it provides a mixture of general information about the market, new coins to consider, and news about existing coins. It doesn't have perfectly up-to-date info like Market Analyst though, so it's going to be a day or so behind. Another super useful GPT for trading is Chart Analyst, which allows you to upload stock or crypto charts and get feedback based on the GPT's knowledge about technical analysis or the practice of examining a price chart to make trading decisions. We can upload basic charts like this and get some useful, albeit incomplete, info. Or we can include technical indicators like RSI, Bollinger Bands, etc., like in this Bitcoin chart, and get much more nuanced recommendations. When we gave it the basic chart, Chart Analyst was highly confident it was a buy, but when we included the indicators, that confidence level went down to moderate. This goes to show, the more info you can give it, the better. There are also a handful of GPTs that make starting a business or a side hustle a ton easier. The most obvious one is a logo creator, which allows you to generate a logo for your business with a short prompt and dialogue. Simply follow the logo creator sequence about the style, complexity, and colors you want, and voila, we've got a pretty great logo. But it doesn't include words by default, so if we want words in the logo, simply specify that. And there we have it. We've got our logo for Jim's Mowing. Pretty impressive, if you ask me. Let's say you have an idea for a business, but you don't know if it's good or you don't know where to start. Check out Market Maven, which will walk you through the steps to answer those questions. Things like market research, competitive analysis, and more. Although I think we can shut the door on the Bluetooth mowing idea I explored here. If you're selling physical products online, this next one's for you. It's called Sell Me This Pen, and it allows you to upload a picture of any product and receive a description, specifications, and suggested selling price of that product. You could use this for Etsy, Depop, your e-commerce store, and so much more. This one is super impressive. For example, I gave it an image of a Nike Air Max, and it was able to identify that it was an Air Max, write the description, and even provide some insights on how we should price the product. So, what do you think? Is ChatGPT Plus worth the $20 for you? Let me know why or why not in the comments. And as always, if you want to keep the AI world in your orbit, smash that subscribe button and be sure to check out these other videos.